Namaste, welcome to Relish Delish. Wishing you all a happy Canada Day. Today we are going to make a sweet dish. It's an Indian Punjabi dessert recipe which is called the Firni. Now Firni is made with rice. So I thought today since it's July 1st, I will make this. It's a white colored Firni and we'll garnish it with some red strawberries, strawberry syrup. So in order to make the Firni, you need basmati rice. So here I have some basmati rice. It's about 1/4, slightly more than 1/4 cup of basmati rice. We have to soak this at least for a couple of hours. So I soaked this about 2 hours back in water, in cold water, washed and soaked. And then I have ground this. I'll show you the consistency. It's like broken rice. So when we make a rice pudding, we make it out of rice. The only difference between kheer, which is pudding, and firni is that this is made with slightly broken rice, so it's easier to cook that way. And then of course we need sugar, so here I have some 1 cup of sugar. I'll be using the sugar to make the firni as well as the strawberry syrup. We of course will need cardamoms, so some crushed green cardamoms. What's Indian dessert without some cardamoms? Then we'll need some milk. So since I didn't have whole milk, I'm going to be using 2% milk. So to give it a creamier texture, I'll be also using some whipping cream to make it creamier. And of course, it's July, so what better fruit to garnish this firni other than strawberries, a favorite in our family. So we'll be making a fresh strawberry syrup. So we take a heavy bottomed pan, that's very essential. You don't want the firni to stick to the bottom of the pan. Now, I put the milk in here. I'm going to be adding the rice now, along with the sugar. I'll put in half the sugar. I'll reserve some for the strawberry syrup. Mix it all up. And this will take about at least 30 minutes to cook, for the rice to cook. So it's very important that you keep stirring this in between so as the rice doesn't stick to the bottom of the pan. So while the firni is cooking, we would be making the strawberry syrup. I have here about 2 cups of strawberry cut into slices. So about half of it will go into the pan. We'll reserve some for later. I'll add some sugar to this. About 1 cup of water. And a teaspoon of vanilla essence. Now we stir this. And let the strawberries cook in this, and then we're going to, after it's cooked, the syrup is done, we're going to add the reserved strawberries. It's been about 20 minutes now, and as you can see, the rice is almost cooked. So this is the stage where I'm going to be adding in the cream. Give it a stir. And also the cardamom. This has been crushed. It's very important that you use fresh cardamoms for this. Nothing smells and tastes as good as fresh green cardamoms. So this needs to be thickened a little more. I would say about 10 minutes. But it's very essential that I keep stirring it at this stage so that the firni doesn't stick to the bottom of the pan. So as you can see, the firni is getting done now. It's almost there. So it's very important that there are no lumps in the rice. So this is why you keep stirring it regularly and in the final stages. And once it's done, once it cools, it will thicken even a little bit more. So I'm going to be switching off the flame now, because I think it's done. so I'll just put it off and then I'm just going to cover it up and let it leave it to cool. So as you can see, the syrup is also thickening. It's almost half the quantity. It's reduced to half the quantity of the strawberries and the water that we put in and the sugar. So this is the right consistency. As this will cool, the syrup will also thicken. So I'm going to switch off the flame and add in the reserved strawberries at this stage and give it a stir. So just leave it to cool. And then once everything is cooled, we will assemble the firni in cups. So the firni has been cooling for a while. So it's almost set now. You can see the consistency. In India, usually firnis are served in terracotta or earthenware. I'm going to give it, because the presentation looks nicer, because this is strawberry firni. So just layer the top, strawberry layer on top. And that's the main difference between kheer and firni. Kheer is, the consistency is a little watery, whereas firni is supposed to be thick. So here you go, strawberry firni. Happy Canada Day!